So welcome to part 4 on this series on setting up Cisco Call Manager. So in the past 3 parts we have gone through hardware, we have gone through some initial configs, and we have successfully connected a 7911 and a 7906. Since then I've gone ahead and attached this 7970 simply because it's got a much nicer screen that works better with the camera. So yeah, that's why I went with this here for the video. Look at that. Shiny. It's actually a touchscreen as well, but not that that's of use to the video. But what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be setting up paging so that you can pick up a phone, dial a number, and have your voice come out of every other phone and annoy everybody in the office or home or whatever. It's pretty damn easy to set up actually, so let's head to the computer. So here we are back at the console on our router. So there's a few things we need to do here. So first, obviously, we're going to want to enter conft and we're going to be creating a new directory number. So we're going to do ephone-dn, and you can give this any number you want, literally any number. I'm going to make this simple. I'm going to make it 3999. Apparently I can't put a number that big for a directory number. What's the highest? I can only do up to 150, so I'll just do 150 for this. And I am going to give it a number though, of 3999. There we go. Messed that up, didn't I? Now we're going to set this as a paging group. Just like that. Now all we need to do is assign this directory number to each phone in the system. So if we do ephone1 and do paging dn and then 150, that's linking that new directory number we just created to ephone1. Ephone 2, paging directory number 150, and I spelled paging wrong. So yeah, we're just going to basically go through all the phones I've set up in the system. How many did I set up? I only set up 3, I think. Yeah, there's only 3 phones in the system, so that's done. So let's go to the phones and actually test it out. Before we actually go back to the phones, I should probably do the obligatory do right, so that you don't lose your config if you restart the router. Always do that after making a change. So here we are back at the phones. Yes, this has been a very quick video, hasn't it? So let's actually pick up a phone and we're going to dial 3999. Look at that, it's paging on there. It actually says paging. Probably can't see that. No. It just vanished, but trust me, it's paging. So we can end that call, and let's do it from the other phone here to the other phone, just so you know that it's working. Okay, it's a bit quiet on that phone for some reason. Let's turn it up a bit. There you go. Blah. Now there are a few other configs you can do. When you set the paging group, you can actually set a volume, I believe. So that issue I had there where I turned down the speaker volume previously, your page message will come out at a set volume. I'm not going to go through configuring that in this video. It's pretty easy to do. I think you do it on a directory number when you type paging. If you do a question mark, I'm pretty sure you'll find it right there and then. So that's how you set up paging on Cisco CallManager Express. Check out the next video in this series where we're going to be looking at how to do call parking, so that you can take all them annoying calls that come in and just put them in a park slot and move them to a different phone. It's basically a glorified transfer. Anyway, see you in that video.